everybody. This is Carl Albrecht here in Nashville in my little home studio. No bells and whistles, no tricks. Today I'm talking about the Yamaha EAD10. And I've already got it mounted on the kick drum. And it's really just a module or a pickup with stereo microphones and a kick drum trigger. So even with me talking, what you're hearing is the stereo mics. And Yamaha has just designed this microphone system to pick up a stereo image of the whole kit. So you're hearing, here's my mounted hat, here's the regular hi-hat, and the kick drum is being triggered besides hearing the microphone. So you can adjust that. All the adjustments can be made. You can set reverb, you have gate, you have wah, you have all these interesting effects. And you know, you can layer in whatever sounds you want. I did a review for a magazine, so I'm just kind of remembering what I wrote there. But there's 50 presets and over 200 user kits, and you can add in with the sounds. You have 127 kick drums, 77 snare drums, 76 different toms if you use other triggers, 70 cymbals, and 127 percussion sounds. So on the trigger pad, you just have this little drum. And I didn't mix things up too much. I used the Arena 1 setting, but I did a little tweaking. But let me go back to Arena. Just as this is right out of the box. This is 001. That's the kick drum sound. And the snare drum, I'm going to turn off. I actually have a little tambourine, but I'm going to turn that off. And on the second snare, I had something else. I'm going to shut that off. So you're just hearing the mounted stereo mics and the kick drum trigger. Here's minus the kick drum trigger. This is just the kit. So okay. So it's really amazing the way they designed that, and it works great. If you're in a small venue or a church or something where you don't have the equipment to set up, you may just feel like, well, I'm a pro and I've got a bunch of stuff. That's fine. But for small venues, this actually would work in that. And I've used it to supplement my recording setup here in my studio, as well as for some live gigs, as just an extra effect if you want to go to that trouble. So it works awesome. You can see tons of other reviews on YouTube, so I'm just adding to the plethora of great reviews for this product. So anyway, Yamaha's done great with that. But anyway, that's the sound of it. I'm going to go back to what I've tweaked into it for my Arena setup. Now, here's the cowbell on the pad. I don't know if you can see the other mics. I swear I am not using them. I'm not using any of the other mics on the kit. I'm only using this, okay? So what you hear in the video is strictly off of the unit mounted on the kick drum. And it's pretty amazing in terms of, like, I think the spacing and the picture that it creates, okay? So here is my Arena version. Where's it at? There it is. So, I've added a little bit more to the second snare. Could shut that off. That's just my snare. Here's theirs added. Here's my snare. Just a little fatter. Pretty much an image of this snare, and I'm using I use a bunch of different snares. But the fun thing about this is, like, whatever kit or cymbals you're using, or snare or toms, pretty much you're hearing that, right? So way you play is really coming across. Triggers, natural sounds, kind of wacky sounds. We're going to show some more videos, but some friends were just saying, show us how this really works. And it really does work. So we may do some play along with song things too. And that's where it really comes in as a great practice tool, but it's also a real professional technical thing that they've come up with here. This just isn't for your practice room. I really do see the potential for doing drum programming, cinematic kind of stuff, some far out sounds, and I'll be showing you some of that as I experiment with it myself, okay? So have a great day. More news about the Yamaha EAD10 soon.